see trees of green, red roses too. I see them bloom for me and you. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world.
Means podcast. I'm your host, Jeff Simmons. And this is the only podcast that focuses on my borough, the amazing borough of Queens and all we have to offer. Each week, this podcast is brought to you by the Queens Economic Development Corporation and Queens Tourism Council, which promote Queens as a vibrant 24/7 destination with something for everyone, whether you live here, work here, or you just may want to visit. And I hope you do. This past weekend, I finished all of my holiday cards. I got all of the decorations up. I even took some time to have some hot chocolate with marshmallows. Yes, it is that time of year again, and I know I go overboard. I wish you a very happy Hanukkah this week, and I hope that over the next few weeks, you're able to spend some time with friends and loved ones. This new variant's arrival just as the holidays are kicking in is really off-putting, but it's also a reminder that we still have to take precautions. So get your booster shot and wear a mask indoors. Even if we are putting together some small gatherings, I'm sure that your food and your drink choices are going to be central to your plans. What to cook, what to order, what to bake, what to pour. I have been to so many holiday gatherings over the years that I have lost count of the buckets of eggnog, apple cider, the peppermint bark, the ham, and cookies topped with Hershey's Kisses that I've had. My favorite drink this time of year is the Nutty Irishman. That is kicking in about another week. There is one type of Italian pastry that I always have had to try when I'm at a party. I'm sure you know it well. It's the panettone. And if you've had one, you know what I'm talking about. And if you haven't, well, I have the perfect opportunity for you to try not just one, but a number of types starting on December 9th. That is when the inaugural Panettone Festival will be held in Long Island City, just in time to usher in this holiday season. I caught up with Laura Altamari, principal of Fine Tastes LLC based in Queens, to find out what's in store. Laura Altamari, principal of Fine Tastes LLC, based in Queens. Welcome to the It's in Queens podcast.
Hello, nice to chat with you again. Great to be here.
The big question, who came up with this idea to present the New York Panettone Festival?
So there's a gentleman by the name of Cristiano Rossi. He is an Italian entrepreneur in the food industry. And last year during the Christmas holidays, he decided to sell some artisanal panettone at his Brooklyn cafe. And the customer feedback was so successful. Just the week before Christmas, they completely sold out. And he just thought more people should know about panettone. And he's about to open a cafe coming up in Long Island City in January. And he said he would like to entree into Long Island City with bringing this festival about this panettone that he loves so much and is so passionate about.
So what is the appeal of panettone?
So, it's like really no other desserts. It takes 2 days of leavening to make it, but the way I could best describe it is like a giant popover, and it's very buttery inside, and there's a range of fillings for it. No one's ever really replicated it other than the Italians, and it has chocolate or apricots, figs, caramel, pistachio, candied fruit inside, raisins with different toppings on the outside. And I think it's just something that's different than anything else that comes out around the holidays.
And for anyone who's never tried it, what is it? Talk a little about its history.
So the history, it comes from Milano. and a family by the name of Attilini fell in love with the daughter of Tony, a baker in Porta Velicina in Milano. And in order to be close to his beloved, he decided to become a pastry chef and work in the workshop of this girl's father. And so it was kind of created and driven by love to show his skills. And he discovered that, you know, with this plain cake, I could make the bread richer. I could add candy fruits and raisins to it. And it was something that had never been done in Italy before. And it was very appreciated. So providing, you know, the baker with a wider clientele, people came from everywhere. And they named it Pan del Tone because it was the daughter of Tony. And then they transformed it into panettone. They made it the one word. So the Italians kind of recognize it as panettone being about love and wonder. And if you don't try it, you could never say, you could at least say that you've been in love once in your life.
So Laura, if people would like to say fall in love with panettone and discover this and, you know, just find, have such a wonderful time starting Thursday the 9th, what will take place?
So on December 9th, it will take place at the Piazza, which is located at 5241 Center Boulevard. And it is right at the front of the Long Island City waterfront. And the New York skyline will be in the background. And there will be a number of pastry chefs that are from Italy and also from New York. Some in the United States, chocolatiers will be there also from Miami, world class chocolatiers. And we also will have a Lavazza coffee bar. They will be doing cappuccinos and espressos. So it will be very festive. They'll have dining pods also to keep people warm if it's a little chilly.
And this all sounds so wonderful. I'm curious who some of the chefs are who are going to be participating.
Yeah, there's about a dozen chefs, including, I mean, he's so lucky to have Ingenio Massare. He's a prestigious world champion pastry chef. He has a list of awards. If you go on to the website, panettonenewyork.com, you can pull up the Mastri Pasticceri, and you could see, you know, all of the chefs that are listed, but especially him. You know, to get someone of his caliber, you know, he's the winner of like the best pastry chef in Europe, best pastry chef in Italy. And, you know, they all have their own specialties. You know, Gennaro Esposito, he's a 2 Michelin star chef. Roberto Rinaldini, he's a 7-time winner of a world championship. There's Gabriele Ciacci. He's a panettone champion. Giuseppe Zippo, another champion. Alessandro Maglione is a winner of a championship with panettone as well. Then there's also Joseph Settepani. He's from New York, as well as Gary Rulli, also from New York. And then there's Alessandro Slama. He also won a panettone championship. Two ladies, Isabel Garcia Nevet, they are world champion chocolatiers, and they will have chocolate for people to purchase and taste at the event as well.
And you mentioned, Jeff, I've got to say this right, Ingenio Massare. Well, his panettone is considered the best in the world. What makes it so special?
You know, I think it's just the ingredients that he uses. You know, everything is sourced from Italy, from Milan, and the ingredients that he uses, very, very different from what anybody else does in the world, the preparation of it. But I'm sure there's still a little secret that he's not telling everybody.
Maybe that night, maybe that day. So, of course, whenever I'm having some type of pastry, I have to have something to drink with it. What are some of the best types of drinks to pair with panettone?
So with panettone, there's usually a sweet wine called Zabibbio. And it's the same wine which candied fruits are macerated inside the panettone. Or, of course, a lot of people know Moscato. That's from the land of panettone. And I personally love Moscato. That's just a real grapey kind of nice. It's not sweet at all. And, you know, there is going to be the Lavazza coffee bar there, too. So an espresso or, you know, one of the many cappuccino drinks that they're going to be doing, I would have that with a panettone also. But if you really want to have it like an Italian, you would do it with one of the sweeter dessert wines.
So for anyone who's never had panettone before, if they're coming to the event, what do you recommend people try?
So definitely try the traditional panettone of each of the pastry chefs, because each one of them, as I previously said, specializes in, you know, their own fillings. You know, some are with the white figs, which are very, very rare to find, very hard to, you know, come across in the United States. Some are marinated in the Zabibbo, which is that, you know, sweet Italian wine that I mentioned, and chocolate. One has the apricots from Vesuvius, and one also has saffron from San Gimignano with whiskey and chamomile in it. So very, very different flavors for people to try. But if you're a first time panettone, I would go just with the regular one that has the candied fruit and the raisins in it. And they will be giving tastings too, so you can go around and taste and see what you like. And then you can, you know, buy one there and take it home and have it for the holidays.
Remind our listeners where people should go and when.
So it's going to be from December 9th to the 12th, and then the 16th to the 19th. And it's from 11 a.m. to 7 p.m. It's going to be at the Piazza at 5241 Center Boulevard in Long Island City. And their website is panettonenewyork.com. You can also go to the website and pre-order the panettone to purchase if you can't make it to the festival. But we highly recommend coming for an experience like this. And this, even though it is the inaugural event that's happening, I think year over year, they're going to be adding more to it. It will be panettone, it'll be chocolates, it will be all kinds of Italian delicacies. I mean, we've had numerous conversations. The space that we're having it at this year only allows for a dozen or so spaces. And, you know, next year, maybe we find a bigger space and bring more of the Italian culture into this, because it's just, it's very, very special. It's going to feel like, you know, one of those outdoor Christmas markets in Europe. That's the feel that it's going to be. So with the skyline of New York City behind you, it's just, it's going to be spectacular. They're very, very excited about this.
It is the perfect time of year to do something like this. Laura Altamari, I want to thank you so much for appearing here on the It's in Queens podcast today.
Thank you so much. So glad to speak with you. You know, I love talking about all the events that are coming up in Queens. It's a very special place. And it's nice to see, you know, a nice event happening right before the holiday hits. So perfect timing.
Thank you so much.
You're very welcome.
And after the interview, when Laura and I kept talking, we talked about the chef's new restaurant. It's called Santa Chiara, and it's going to open in early 2022, maybe as early as January. The address will be 52-41 Center Boulevard, so make sure to look out for it. I know I will. If you're heading to the Panettone Festival, please, please, please take some pictures. Share them on Instagram and Twitter. I want to know what they look like, but so does the Queens Tourism Council, because you should tag us. Use the hashtag #ItsInQueens or tag us at #ItsInQueens. Who knows? Your photo could become our photo of the week. And if you've not visited our website, then head over to itsinqueens.com and you could find out more about this event and really all types of events that are happening in our amazing borough. there's a lot to sort through. That's a good thing, and much more on the horizon, so you can celebrate the holidays. But each week, our Rob McKay of the Queens Economic Development Corporation and Queens Tourism Council pours through all the events, and he selects a few highlights that you should know about. Here's this week's report.
Hi, Jeff. In a clear sign of the times, it's all about wreath making this week. I'm sure that you're very good at making wreaths yourselves, but I personally could use a little help. Luckily, the Queens County Farm Museum is going to be hosting not one, not two, not three, not four, but 8 wreath making workshops between December 4th and December 12th. They're going to be going on twice a day at 10 a.m. and 1 p.m. on December 4th, 5th, 11th, and 12th. You know, it's a basic workshop to teach you how to deck the halls with evergreen bows. Like I said, they're eight sessions, so it's kind of you can make it fit into your schedule. And Queens County Farm Museum is also a wonderful place to go in December. Hopefully to make the experience absolutely perfect. It'll snow between now and anyone's visit. The other place for wreath making is Queens Botanical Gardens, kind of obviously, right? They're going to be giving workshops on how to create a wreath with pine, fir, and other evergreens. They will be offering 3 sessions. That would be December 5th at 11 and 2 p.m. and December 11th at 11. So there are 3 sessions there, 8 sessions at the Queens County Farm Museum. I expect you to have a very beautiful, presentable apartment before the next week, before the next interview for It's in Queens. All right? Thank you.
Thanks, Rob. I'm still very much focused on the Panettone. I hope to see you there. Remember, it starts on December 9th. As I get ready to wrap up this week's episode, I again want to thank you for making the It's in Queens podcast a part of your day. I encourage you to visit our YouTube page and check out all of the earlier podcasts. You can learn more about our cultural institutions and business leaders and entertainers who I've talked with. I hope to bring you more of these voices in 2022, so make sure to let us know who you'd like to hear from. And this holiday season, please make sure to shop local as often as you can. Support your small businesses in Queens. This pandemic has closed so many establishments, so do what you can to help your local business and, of course, help your local restaurants as well. Together, we will get through this. I'm your host, Jeff Simmons, and that's it for the It's in Queens podcast this week.
I see trees of green, red roses too. I see them bloom for me and you. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. I see skies of blue and clouds of white, the bright blessed day, the dark sacred night. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. The colors of the rainbow, so pretty in the sky.